Good evening and welcome to a new quick edit video. This time I want to show you the post-processing for a nighttime star trail image. So let's begin this video with the before and after images. Now before I start the editing, I want to say you can fake star trails with just one image, but it probably won't look real. So in this case, I took about 100 images from the same position as you can see. And I'm going to blend all those images together later in Photoshop. But for now, let's start the basic editing. So of course, first I'm going to the lens correction tab and I'm activating those settings. And then I want to choose a different camera profile. And I think Adobe Portrait works pretty nice on nighttime images. And I also want to set the white balance. And in this case, I want to have a nice blue sky, so I'm decreasing the temperature. And I think that looks good. And as this image is rather dark, I'm going to increase the exposure just a little bit and add some highlights as well. And of course, I can also increase the shadows. And to get some more structure in this image, I'm increasing the clarity a bit. Now, normally I would go on with local adjustments, but for this image, I think I skip it for the moment at least. And I want to jump into the color grading right away. And for the orange color tones, I want to turn down the saturation a bit. And I think for yellow as well. And then I want to increase the saturation of the blue color tones. And then head over to the split toning. Instead of applying a warm color to the highlights, I'm going with a cold color tone this time. Okay, something around here looks nice. And for the shadows, I'm choosing a colder color tone as well. And then of course I want to sharpen the image a little bit. And also I want to apply some noise reduction as I shot at a rather high ISO. And that's it for the editing in Lightroom. Now, of course, I need to apply the editing to all the other images I took throughout the series. So I'm selecting them all and I'm pressing sync to synchronize the settings. Now you can see the first images are really blue, but in this case, it doesn't really matter that much. So I'm just leaving it as it is. One thing I'd like to change though, I want to add some kind of fog to this particular image to use as my foreground image. So for this, I'm just grabbing the brush tool and set the flow to something around 40. And then I need to kind of brush in those foggy fields without making it look unnatural. And to add the fog, I'm just decreasing the dehaze. And here you got to be really careful not to overdo it. Also, to not get too much noise, I'm going to add some noise reduction for this brush. And now I just need to play around with the dehaze settings. Okay, I think that looks kind of good. And if it doesn't work out, I can change it later. So the next step is to export all the images I just edited and merge them in Photoshop. Then once the export process has finished, I of course need to load every single image into Photoshop and place them over each other. Okay, now as I have placed all the images in Photoshop, I'm going to select them all and change the blending mode to lighten. And there you have the star trails. To further edit the image, I'm going to merge all those layers first, as this will slow Photoshop down otherwise. And next, I want to place my foreground layer into it. And then, of course, I need to mask out the sky. Therefore, I'm just using a black brush tool. And actually, I think that haze effect looks really ugly, so I'm going to delete that layer. But I still want to work on the foreground because it kind of looks ugly due to the blending mode change of all the layers. So therefore, I'm just grabbing one of the pictures I previously exported from Lightroom, and I just place it over the star trail image. And again, I'm masking out the sky. And as you can see, the foreground now looks way better. But I still want to get rid of some of the lights which are not part of the sky. For example, the light of the car coming through the image. And I want to reduce those city lights as well. Okay, and again, I'm merging all those layers. Next, I want to get rid of all the planes flying through the image, because that looks weird to me. And therefore, I'm just using the spot healing brush. And here you can just paint over all those streaks. Now I want to edit this image a little bit more. So I think first I'm going to apply some local glow, and therefore I'm applying a new layer and set the blending mode to soft light. Then I'm picking a really bright color somewhere in this area and choose the brush tool, make it big and soft, and brush in where I want to have the glow. And of course, at the moment, this effect is pretty heavy, so I'm reducing the opacity. And again, I'm merging those two layers. And finally, I want to check the Nick collection if I can apply another effect. And actually, I think I'm going with the Pro Contrast filter and apply some of the correct contrast, just so the stars in the skies pop out a little bit more. And I think that's it for editing this image. So I hope this little Star Trail quick edit video was helpful, and if you'd like to see more content like this, then please feel free to subscribe to my channel. And thank you very much for watching this video.